Today we are going to learn chapter number 1, accounting and its terminology. This is the 6th part of the same video. The 1 to 5 part is already linked in the description. In this video we are going to learn some terminology related to assets. We already know the liability. As we know, there is a liability in the business. That liability, because of that liability we can get the asset. So liability and asset both are the two sides of the balance sheet. So here asset means something that is helpful in the business. So definition of the asset is, an asset are resources that own and control by company which can use to generate profit. So here the asset that are owned by company and that can be helpful to generate profit is called asset. That means to run the business smoothly, whatever we are using in the business is called asset. Let's say the example of asset is land and building, or let's say furniture or vehicle, computer, copyright, trademark, etc. are the example of the asset. That means asset are something that is useful in a business to run the business smoothly and nicely. Here asset are again divided into different category, that are non-current asset, current asset and fictitious asset. Non-current asset means the way we know the liability. Liability is also divided into category according to time, that is non-current and current. So here also assets are also divided into category for time, that means non-current asset. According to the name of the asset, non-current asset are those assets that are going to stay in the business for longer period of time. That's why it is called non-current asset. Non-current asset means the example of non-current asset are building, furniture, machinery, copyright, patent, goodwill, etc. So that are the non-current asset of the business. Current asset are those asset, they are not going to stay more than 1 year. That means the money of that asset is converted into cash within a 1 year, that is called current asset. The example of current asset are bank balance, raw material stock, semi-furnished goods stock, finished goods stock, or less say debtors or business receivable, that are the current asset. So here non-current and current asset are main two part of the asset. Apart from that, there is another asset called fictitious asset. Fictitious asset means those asset that can be not realized, that means the money cannot be realized from that, that are useful in the business, that are the expenses that we are making for the business purpose, but those asset cannot be sell, that is called fictitious asset. That means the realization value of this asset will be zero. But when we are spending the money for this asset, the benefit of that expenditure we can take for more than 1 year. That's why it is also called spread revenue expenditure. And the other name of fictitious asset is deferred revenue expenditure. These are the assets which we are incurring for one time, and the benefit of that asset we are taking for long period of time. Let's say advertisement expenditure. If we are spending money for the advertisement expenditure, that money for that we are taking benefit of that for more than 2, 3 or 5 years. That's why it is called fictitious asset, and that can be write off during the particular period of time until that we are taking the benefit of that asset. So this is the fictitious asset. Okay, again non-current asset are divided into two category called tangible asset and intangible asset. Tangible asset means those assets, they are physically exist, that can be seen or touched. That is called tangible asset. Let's say building, vehicle, furniture, etc. That are the tangible asset. And intangible asset are those asset that is physically not exist, that cannot be touched or seen. That is called intangible asset. The example of intangible asset are patent, trademark, copyright, goodwill, etc. are called intangible asset. The benefit of that can be taken in the business, but the physical existence of that asset is not there, are called intangible asset. So these are the again two part of the non-current asset. Current asset, from that if we are going to exclude the stock, that is called liquid asset. That means the stock cannot be converted into money quickly. So the asset that cannot convert quickly in the cash, that is excluded from the current asset, are called liquid asset. Liquid asset are those asset, the money of that can be converted into cash very quickly, are called liquid asset. So here we can see the total asset is, the asset is divided into three category called non-current asset, current assets and fixed asset. Current, non-current asset are also divided into two category called tangible asset and intangible asset. And current asset, if we are going to exclude from current asset, stock we are going to exclude, it is called liquid asset. And fixed asset, as we know, is the realization value is zero. So here we can see all the asset together, but so this is the all the asset related discussion. In our next video we are going to see some more terminology of the accounting. Thank you for watching this video.